over 18 points in 84. Smith becomes the third player in Knicks history to win the Sixth Man of the Year award and first since John Starks did it back in 1997. Both Starks and Smith led the NBA. If Phil Jackson returns to coaching, Cleveland is doing its part to make it do it for the Cavaliers. ESPN.com reports that the team has reached out to Jackson about their coaching vacancy. Cleveland fired Byron Scott last week. And in baseball, CeCe Sabathia and Matt Moore have each won their last three starts, and tonight they'll face off in a pitcher's duel. Coverage begins at 7 Eastern on ESPN. Our Baseball Tonight crew has a preview.
Let's say you're Sabathia. Moore is pitching really well. Any different at all in the frame of mind?
I always like to be on Moore's side. I mean, you're facing one of the premier guys in the game in Sabathia. You're trying to pick it up a notch. Both of these guys, they're doing it different. I think Matt Moore is one of the better young arms in the game. I think he's on his way to being a very good big pitcher. CeCe is one of the reasons why the Yankees are where they are. We talked about this. I had the Yankees with no shot at doing anything.
Really well.
Him being consistent at the top of that rotation with Pettit behind him has been huge. He's learning how to pitch with a little bit different stuff and degree so far.
Just as a quick aside, you were that dominant guy. So who did you get kind of fired up? Who was CeCe to you?
It was early in my career. Randy,
okay.
Pedro, guys like that. You know, Maddox and Blavin and Schmaltz, guys like that.
All right, that's what Matt Moore is looking at as he takes a CeCe Sabathia. That's Monday, 7 Eastern time. I want to remind everybody, you'll be able to. One is being played. Yankees and Rays, Monday, 7 o'clock Eastern time.
On the pitch, we've got a biter. Liverpool's Uruguayan forward Luis Suarez bit the arm of Chelsea defender Branislav Ivanovic during Sunday's 2-2 draw between Liverpool and the Blues. Not the first time Suarez has taken a chomp out of someone. Suarez served a 7-game suspension for a bite during a Dutch League match in 20.
1 week ago today at 2:50 Eastern, the first of two bombs exploded near the Boston Marathon finish line, killing three and wounding more than 180 islanders for those affected. Emotional day in the Boston area after a difficult week. Our Sports Center special continues after this.
Oh boy.
Investment management combined with investment servicing. Bringing the power of investments to people's lives.
Gods and had him created. World Series winner? Check. AL MVP? Sure. He's Miguel Cabrera, one of the best pure hitters in baseball, and he's about to take the stage. Sunday Night Baseball presented by Taco Bell, Braves Tigers at 8 on ESPN.
Hey, want to tee it up? Then go to Golf Destinations on demand.
Simply tune in to Searchlight Channel 888. Click on Travel and Leisure and select Golf Destinations. On Comcast On Demand. Brought to you by your local Toyota dealer. Now's the time to go places with Toyota. Pam's Ocean City Golf Getaways, the official golf package provider of Ocean City, Maryland. And the Green Turtle Sports Bar and Grill. Meet you at the Turtle and plan your next golf vacation at Golf Destinations On Demand.
Suffering from allergy congestion, Allegra D decongestion.
Kind of feel like he belongs in the first round, and a lot of people still think that he's the best quarterback in this draft.
And the Browns, an interesting spot. They've been mentioned as a possibility for a trade. Todd, why Tyler Eifert to the Browns now?
You look at where they are, and everyone's associated D. Milliner, the cornerback from Alabama. Well, what if they don't want to take Milliner at 6? And what if there's a possibility to trade out? I think that's what Cleveland will do. Jordan, or maybe a D. Milliner cornerback with that first pick, and then another impact player. I went with Tavon Austin from West Virginia because he's an impact player. So I think you go outside of the quarterback position 39. Let's say you don't get a cornerback with these first two.
Obviously, to find these players, building for next year's draft already, stockpiling picks there. So then you go with the three picks, as you said, that's three hole fillers. That's, that takes the eight needs down to five, and then you have the remainder of your draft to try to find some guys there, undrafted free agents as well. So I think this draft maybe solidifies half your needs, maybe more. You build for next year's draft, and in a three-year period, you may have yourself a playoff-caliber team. But it all begins in this draft, critical one for John Mutt.
Even drop off free boxes. I wear a lot of hats. Well, technically, I wear one. The U.S. Postal Service. No business too small.
This is not my home. There, I said it. They don't have pictures of my kids. They don't have my yoga mat. And still, I feel at home. Could it be the flat screen TV?
That's that. You know, me working hard off the field, I get the results on the field. That's just playing great football.
Revis, the latest veteran defensive player to be traded for a first-round pick over the last 10 years. The Jets received the 13th overall pick from...
with blitzes and scheme. And the thing about Darrell Revis, he gives you an opportunity to lock down their number one receiver and say, get up there, press that guy, make sure you take him out of the game, and that's going to give us the opportunity, whether it's linebackers, whether it's safeties, to get to your quarterback through scheme. And that's what he does for the New York and has done for the New York Jets.
We played against Rex a lot when he was in Baltimore and then with the Jets in Indianapolis. And we learned that the whole prep corners, if he can cover man-to-man on your outside receivers, then he's in a position where he can do all manner of positions. He has to do other things that are not as effective. And we saw that, I think, last year.
How will he impact the Bucs secondary that also added DeSean Bolton?
Is he healthy? I mean, that's the biggest
question.
That's the biggest question. If he's healthy, he's going to give them an opportunity to have one side of the football field completely shut down. They've got two young safeties, very good players, guys that will come up in the box, guys that will defend. And you've got one cornerback in that situation now that
allows you to play all your coverages off him. You can now help. So you don't have to worry about entering a safety so much on his side because he's a great run defender. He's a great force guy. He's a great tackler. So he literally played different coverages off of him. For a defensive coach like Greg Schiano, that's a huge...
For Revis to stay put, it simply wasn't in the cards, and so Revis Island now packing up and headed...
Yeah, well, he was a local kid down in Philadelphia, so we got to know each other very well. He ended up going to Florida with a good friend of mine.
And strength there.
This guy has had an All-American type season.
At the point of attack, very good. You know, very good run stopper, and we'll also...
trade we